Starting the recording and from now. Okay.
Perfect. I've got the great pleasure to introduce Ralf Hilgenstock to you. He works for Elidia. Actually, he doesn't just work for Elidia, he's one of the people running Elidia, one of the Moodle partners, well, the Moodle partner in Germany. And he's been Moodling for a long, long time. I just looked at the slide, it's over 10 years. So he's involved in lots and lots of projects. And today he will tell us about, well, how they solved the need that larger companies have when they work in e-learning, and how they managed to provide a system that runs well together with Moodle to be able to solve problems that larger companies had when employing e-learning solutions. If you have any questions, I'm sure you can use the chat, and I will try and make sure that no question gets missed. You can raise your hand as well, and there'll be discussion at the end, of course. Okay, so I'll just hand over to you, Ralf, and thank you already for your presentation.
Thanks, Stefan. Stefan is a colleague from me, coming from Essen in Germany. I'm sitting now in Berlin, and I will tell you a little bit about me that you have an impression about it. I'm coming originally from the area of training, especially soft skill training, coaching, and organizational development and consulting processes. And 12, 13 years ago, lots of clients asked us, how can we change things in our training processes, in the consulting processes? And we thought about online supporting. And that was a point where we saw it first time with the Moodle system and said, okay, this is a wonderful system also for companies and bigger organizations, not only for higher education and schools. And we started with localization in Germany at first, built up the German community, and we are working in the community since a lot of years. And also, we are the organization who is organizing the German Moodle MOOCs, as German Moodle conferences. We are working in Berlin with a team of 20 employees and freelancers, and we are giving a lot of different services. Most of them, interestingly, not for schools, not for higher educations, but for nonprofit organization, for governmental organization, and for companies. And that is the reason that we have thought about different solutions that Moodle are offering. Why? If we were in contact with a lot of them, they have asked Moodle is a one. They have told us Moodle is a wonderful tool, and Moodle can do a lot of things for us. But we have a lot of requirements in organizational processes. And if we are working with a tool that is organizing the online courses for us, what can Moodle do for our requirements for the on-site courses? How about the blended learning aspects of training? How can Moodle support us here? And we have thought about this for a long time. And we have checked the programming code and discussed with the core developers. And at the end, we found that it will be possible to do a lot of things in Moodle, but only if you are changing a lot in the core code. And that makes it complicated to maintain the installation. And we said, what are alternatives and what are things where we can Moodle with this powerful tools for the e-learning aspects, but combined with the organizational aspects there. And at the end, we came to a new product. This is C5. And what I will show you in this presentation, what are the in detail requirements our clients asked for, and on the other side, what is the solution that we are offering now for the client? And what's interesting that all the elements we are using are based on open source technology. So open source technology can solve a lot of requirements and requests by a company. I think I will present here a little bit more than from 30 to 40 minutes, and if you have any questions, please ask directly, and you can use the chat, or you can also ask. asked directly via the microphone. In our analysis, we found that Moodle is very great, it had a lot of strengths and also weaknesses. What we can do in Moodle is we can organize all around the online courses. But what were the limitation, as we found at first, was that Moodle cannot be handle tenant concepts and tenant requirements. If we have an international company or a national company with different segments and offices, they asked, how can we separate users so that we have only the users from France, the users from UK, the users from Italy, the users from US in one area, and have a manager who can handle only this one, who can only enroll these users into a course, but not the users from another country, from another department. How can you get overview about reports about them? How is it possible to handle this? This is a point where we saw, no, that's exactly not possible. But Moodle is great because of its flexibility, the pedagogical process, and is a lot of options to have different pedagogical concepts in the online courses. The mass of features is very, very great. And all day, if clients are asking for solutions, I can say 98 of the requirements you are asking us Moodle has on board in the standard configuration. Sometimes you have to think about a little bit about workarounds, but most of the time you can do it directly. And in difference to a lot of other LLMs, Moodle has a lot of communicational functionalities and a lot of functionalities that support collaborative works. And this is an aspect where we say there's no other tool that can do it like Moodle for the online courses. The elements there, there's weakness. Moodle is designed for the online training. Moodle is not designed for offline training. There are some tools we can use. For example, there's an add-on plug-in face-to-face where I can handle the enrollments in online training as an additional functionality into an offline courses as an additional functionality in an online training. That's great. It's working great. And we have just implemented it for one client. But if I have only an online training, then this is not a good solution. The online on-site programs are not supported generally. The system-wide reporting in Moodle is limited. That's clear because school organizations and higher education institutions have their own administrational tools for this. And it's not the idea that an LMS should support this. So Moodle has not developed a lot of functionality here in a system-wide reporting, and also not if I need a reporting over a long time, over a decade. So that's not a functionality in Moodle. And what I've mentioned before, no support for tenants. So that was a point, and that was an analysis we found. And then we have asked what are the requirements from our clients. They said, okay, we need the support for on-site course. On-site course can be a two-hour course, can be a course that has three sessions in week one, week two, week three of 4 hours. It's maybe an online course, it may be a blended offering. A blended offering means a combination of an online course and an on-site course, or a combination of three on-site courses plus one online course as an introduction and a finishing online course at the end. There are a lot of different combinations that are possible. And they say, okay, we don't know what we need at the end, but we have the requirement that we have a flexible system that can handle this. It should be tenant-based in the back end. We should like or like to see a tool that is able to publish the courses in individual catalogs. In ideal, the situation that every user get his personal catalog of offerings, depending on the location where he's working, depending on the job description or whatever, and to see a catalog. So it's not required that the employee in Italy should see what an employee in Canada can book. Or someone who is working in administration should not see what is offered for the sales guys. So individualization here on this level was one request. Then it should be possible that an individual could book an offer. It should also be possible that in the back end, a group of users, for example, all salespeople in Paris should join a course. It should be very easy to handle this. Approval may be required so that superior has to confirm if an employee is running through the self-booking process and wants to join a course because he is required for the budget. We need global reports, we need local reports, we need a notification system that automatically notifies users. Maybe if they have missed a course, if they have to repeat a course that has to be done annually, and we need a process for invoicing and payments. That was a collections of the elements, and we started 3 years ago with development of a system that is using this organizational processes, but in the background with Moodle as a tool that has a flexibility for the online elements. And this is a general concept of C5 that we are offering here. The user normally is working on the area below the line. On the right side, he finds a course catalog. It's individual course catalog where he can search for courses, search by date, search by topics, see the information about the course, sees additional alternative offers, and can say, okay, I want to book this course. This data are given to the backend tool, and he gets a confirmation. And from the course catalog also, he gets the access then to the Moodle system and gets the information where the on-site course is, when it starts, when it's end, accommodation information, and all the other things. Going to the Moodle system, and if the Moodle system is connected with a webinar software, he can also join the webinars. From there. In the back end, the administration there can handle all this. It can handle the users who have access to the system. They can prepare a course. They can publish an offer for the course catalog. They can see all the users. They can make the booking processes also, if it's not self-running via the self-booking process or additionally, and has an overview about the notification and the results. So the Moodle system is giving the results directly into the backend. If someone has finished the course, Moodle gives the information into the backend, and there we store this data, and we store this data there for a long time. Even if a user is deleted in the Moodle system, even if the course is deleted in the Moodle system, the final result that the user has finished the course, was successful, what is the final grade, this information is stored in the backend tool there. And how we handle this totally, we are combining three open source tools here. I'm starting at the bottom with the Moodle system. The Moodle system is only handling the learning contents for the online courses. Course content, the web-based trainings, the SCORM packages, the quizzes, the webinars, the collaborative, communicative functionalities. This is all handled in Moodle, and at the end, this is a standard Moodle system. What we have disabled there are all the processes around user management, enrollment, because we are handling this via the backend. What the user sees at, as a course catalog is a Drupal system. Drupal is a content management system, very powerful, with a lot of functionalities. That is the place where the user is logging in, gets an overview about the courses, and we can handle this Drupal system also as a tool that has different entry points for employees from different countries, maybe with different interfaces, all this. And the backend tool is OpenERP. This tool is renamed last year to Odoo. This is an ERP and a CRM system. It's also open source. It's a competitive product to SAP because it has very similar functionalities, which is also very powerful. And what we are handling there are the user accounts, the courses, the course offerings, the reports, and all this is done in the OpenERP. And all these three tools are interconnected via web service. So much only for the technical aspects. I would not like to go more deeply into this. Let's go a little bit more in detail. The user normally logs in into the course catalog, and there he sees a search window. In the search window, he has a global search. He can search for keywords. He can select by department, by region, by time, by type, of course, and see afterwards results. At first, only as a list. In the list, he says, okay, I see the start date and the title of the offerings.
Okay,
and here.
Okay.
Marie, what was the question? I think not. Okay. If he has done the search, he gets the result there, but he doesn't get all information from the course catalog, but he gets only the information that are relevant for him. In the configuration settings, we can also define that in a catalog at first, the participant or employee sees the next courses that are offered in his personal catalogs so that he can see what are the offerings for the next 14 days, maybe. If you're clicking on one of the offers, he sees a presentation of the offers at first with a cost and data. And below he sees what are the elements of this offer. And elements can be an on-site course element or more and online course, including the description, the times, when it starts, when it's end, and gets this information. In the top area, you can add also additional information about this complete offers. And sometimes the user sees, okay, this is not exactly what I'm looking for, but there's also on the right side an information about similar offers. Similar offers are handled by keywords. So it's showing offers that has the same keywords as the course he is seeing in the moment. And so he can see there are alternatives and he can select an alternative course and then select the course he wants to see. He has also a button there to say, okay, I want to book this course. And this starts the registration process. And if in the back end it is defined that the superior has to confirm this before this is okay, or someone else who is responsible for the course, he will get a notification automatically and can confirm the registration there. Afterwards, the participants get an overview about its own personal bookings. And what you can see here is are different tabs. You see here the German interface, and I'm seeing here my bookings. I see also looking back to the history and also offers that I have to approve. This is required for the superiors that they can have an overview for the employees with open approvals and can confirm them here. If I am a trainer, for an on-site course. I see here also my on-site courses and can confirm after the course, you know, the participants who have joined really in the course so that I have a registration for the back end here. In the history area, the participant gets also access to the certificates for a course if it's defined that the course creates a certificate and can see, okay, that was a course for the last 3 years and has access to the certificates of all of these courses. If he is an online course and the online course has started, participant gets here also the direct link to the Moodle course so that he can log in directly to the Moodle courses. This is a single sign-on process so that he doesn't have to log in separately into the Moodle system. And he can come back all the time here and see overview about the courses. This is one of the screens from the backend. The structure of the backend is that I have different functionalities here on the left side menu about user management, about creating and editing courses, to creating and editing offers, handling the registration process, and also access to the reports here. Typically, only the people in the HR department have access here to the back end because they are organizing this. All the elements here are handled by menus and separate pages so that I can see what are the detailed information. Not all of the information will be published in the catalog. Some of the information in the background are only relevant for the organizers so that they have information here that are not published and only visible for them. They see also who are the people who have enrolled to a course, who have booked them, and to the separate date. So there are different several forms for the different types. If you are thinking in detail, what are the information you need for an online course? And what are the information you need for an on-site course? They are very different. So need for an on-site course the information, when did it start? What is on the first day? What is on the second day? What is on the third day? What is about accommodation? What is about travel information? And all this has to be put into the system so that you can publish this or use it for automatic notification here. And if you are thinking about an on-site course, it's completely an online course is completely different because you say, okay, this is a course that is starting on 1st of June, running for 4 weeks, or this is an open course where everyone can register and start all the time. Ellen is asking about prerequisites. Generally, it's possible to define that you have prerequisites, but it's a very individual concept. What are the criteria? Is the criteria based on user information, or is it on other courses they have finished? And we are able to implement this individually for an instance of the course, of the system for a client. If you are creating a new on-site course, this is a form here, you are say, okay, I want to create a new on-site course, add the data. What you see here in the blue fields are mandatory fields, all the others are fields that don't have to be filled out but make mostly sense. But we have also here that you say, okay, you can define a status of the course. In the typical process of the work cycle of a course, you have the situation that at first you are planning. In the second way, you are defining that this course should be published. And at the end, you say, okay, this course has to be deleted from the catalog, but We need at the end this information also for the reports, so that we should not delete it completely, because we need this if we were asked what happened last year in the courses, then we need this information, but only here in the area of the backend. Then we have, if we have created an online course or an on-site course, we have to connect it as an offer, that we say, okay, there's a bundle of courses, or is only one separate element that has to be published as an offer. We need the structure of courses and offers, because we want to combine them, and then we can connect them here. For the offers, we have additional data, because we need the information, when should it be published, when is the booking booking time frame ending, is it an offer that is available permanent and has no limited by times, what is what are the costs of a course. And because we are able to combine different on-site courses, the on-site courses and the online courses in different offers together, it has to calculate the total price here, and this is all possible. Even if someone is canceling a course after registration, should he have to pay a fee for this? It's also possible to define this here. And we can define what is the minimum number of participants, what is the maximum number of participants, should be there a waiting list. All this can be defined here on the in the form for the offers. Then we have to define who can see this offer in the catalog. And we have prepared five areas. At first, the target group, the hierarchy levels, the regions, the departments, and the job description areas. And all the elements in the background can be added continuously by the organization that is using the C5 system, so that they can change elements or add elements if they are coming new to it. And if I have an offer and define that it is only available for the target group of salespeople, then only people who have the personal profile, the information, I'm coming from a sales department, then they will see the offer in the catalog. Others will not see it. This is the concept that I define exactly who has access. If I'm not defining anything, everyone has access. Ellen's questions, we have internal and external organizational clients. Yes, this is possible. We are just in a process of implementation of some individual elements for international company. They have 10,000 employees worldwide, that are their own, but they have a dealer network. Those are the external organizational clients, and the dealer network has their own database. We are connecting them so that the employees of the dealers can register for the platform, but only them, and they get another information, and they get other courses in the system, and we are handling this here via the system also, so that we have different sources for different user groups and integrated in the system. And for the people in South America, they have only access then to the courses in South America, and also the HR or the sales central sales department from South America has only access to their courses and elements. A little bit more the options that we have here, and the strategies and processes here. I can create an LMS course here in the system. This creates directly the course room in Moodle. And I can define who has access as teacher in the Moodle, in the LMS course, so that he is added to the Moodle course directly. If I need a web-based training, I add it to the Moodle course. If I need a webinar session, I put it into the Moodle system. I'm doing this there. I can say, okay, I create from this an online course and I create from this an offer, and then I publish this offer. This is a separate, is a very simple process, and it's much more simpler if I have an on-site course, because I have only to define the on-site course, and then I create the offer and I publish it. Why did I have one more step if I have here the LMS course and the online course? It's a question that's often asked, but what happens in reality that I have an LMS course, for example, and compliance course, or I have a Microsoft Office LMS course, and this is used in different published offers. And then I have to combine it into different offers, and then because of this, I have to create it as a separate instance here in the system that I can combine it in completely individually. Let's have a look on a other scenario. This is a scenario that I have an online course, a Moodle course, and also an on-site course, and both together are bundled to an offer and published as an offer, so that a participant can book one offer and directly he is enrolled into the on-site course and into the online course. And this is possible in this construction. And now I can make a lot of different combinations. A case can say, okay, I have one element or I have multiple elements. I can combine them as I like. I can say, okay, starting is an online course, then an on-site course, then an online course, other online course or two, and then just an on-site session. And at the end, I have a final on-site session or a final online course with a feedback module or whatever. I can copy all of the elements. So if I need a different instance, I can create it with few clicks, a copy, but I can also copy offers so that I say, okay, I want to publish this for different target groups or whatever. These are completely integrated there. The booking process. The typical situation that we thought for the system was that we will offer a self-booking for the employees. But what we see in a lot of companies that they said, okay, we are not very well prepared for self-offering, self-booking processes, because a lot of people, especially the blue-collar people here working in our company, don't have access to a PC, don't have any accounts to a system on their daily workplace. So we need the booking process in the back end by the HR department, and that should or help also to be possible there. And so we need very neat and easy processes there. We need the processes for a single employee. It's also for a group of employees, and that we can do here also. For example, what we see here, maybe a little bit small, we have here the area of the offerings, and I can select here offerings or can search for offerings and select one or multiple offers. And also on the other side in right column, I have the employees. I can search for employees by criteria, by name, by location, whatever. And then I have the combination here for five or six employees and here for one or multiple bookings, and say, okay, I want to enroll them into this offers, and the system is handling this in the background as one process. So it will be possible to say, I want to enroll 500 employees in the compliance course for this year and handle this very easily and not with a lot of manual work. Self-booking by user is another process, is searching, booking, and what I mentioned before, there's also the approval process. It's all handling in the course catalog without any problems. It's very easy to use. In the back end, we have also the notification system. If you have a big organization, there will be a lot of notification for the participants. So this is a confirmation for the enrollment, the confirmation for the approval information for the superior, the information that a course is running, that a course has been canceled, whatever. And all this can be defined in the background, and you can define the notification process, the events that are handling this, and you have also the option individually here to define the content of this. Typically, it's also possible to have this in different languages. If you have an international course, it sometimes makes sense to have this in English, in German, in Italian, in Spanish. And you can edit it directly here in the system without any programming. There are placeholders, and you have to be careful with the placeholders, but you can do all this in the backend of the system. Yes, I think I'm at the end of the presentation. I've told a lot here, and I think there will be a lot of questions. I hope so. Part now.
Right, yes, if you have any questions, type them in the chat, or if you've got your microphone connected, feel free to raise your hand and we'll give you speaking rights. Perhaps you can even unmute yourself. Okay, there's a question by Dot Ralph. You may have covered this, but where do you have your content running from?
What is the content of the company internal trainings? We have the content for the on-site training. They are prepared classical. And we have the content for the online courses. They are added into the Moodle system directly. And as you are working typically with Moodle, you can work with a course. You can import content from one course to another. Or what we are doing very often is that we are working with library courses so that some courses are prepared and is as a template. So, yes. But did it answer your question? Okay, many phones. Would we be able to do what Drupal and ERP is doing, developing the plugins for Moodle? Yes. No, I'm not quite sure. Now, yes, you're asking if it will be possible to handle this in one system. The user doesn't see, the employee doesn't see that he's working in different systems. Drupal cannot create course content in the same way as Moodle can do. The ERP system cannot do the content relating aspects. It's not related. And Moodle cannot do the organizational things. If we try to implement all the organizational aspects into Moodle, especially the tenant-based concepts and ideas, then we have to make a lot of changes in Moodle. For example, if you have a manual enrollment process in Moodle, you see all the users that are registered in the system. And this is one aspect that we tried to solve, but also in the discussion with the core developers, we saw no, the Moodle system is not prepared to make a separation there. So they are in the category for the courses for the Italian employees, that I only see the Italian employees there. It's not possible. And if you try to do it, you have to break up a lot of functionality in the core system of Moodle. And Technically, it's possible, but if you try to make the next security update, the next version update, you need a lot of effort to implement your changes into the system. That doesn't make sense if you need a system that is running for a long time and has to be run as a secure system. Yes.
Any other questions?
This is an interesting question. I understand it in this way. What should be handled from the HR system into Moodle? C5 is not a solution for all and everything. If you have an HR system that is handling these processes, then it's easier, and we are doing this also, to combine the HR system to Moodle. For example, if you have SAP HR functionality running, you can connect the SAP system directly with Moodle. SAP is supporting web services and Moodle is supporting web services. So it's possible to push the users, to push the course elements from HR to from SAP to Moodle. The security aspects, especially the concept of web services is not a direct integration, but it's an exchange of data that is defined exactly. And the web service is a tool between them, and this is a controlled process. The CSV file import-export is an alternative, and it's also running and is acceptable. If you have an administration system that is running well for you, then the combination with Moodle and the data exchange in both directions is possible and is running, and we are doing this for other clients also. This is a discussion you have with every client that you say, okay, does it make sense to implement a new system or does it make sense to connect existing ones? For example, I visited a company with 3,000 employees here in Germany with some dozen offices over the country, and they have a lot of short trainings from 1 hour to 1 day for the employees, and they are organizing all these processes in the moment via Excel files. Reporting. And I think you have an idea what this does mean. And there's a lot of manual work they have to do there. And because they have not an HR system that are covering all the needs, it makes sense for them to switch to C5. Another organization who has an HR system for training processes and all of them running says, okay, we are happy with this system, but we need the connection to Moodle. Then we discuss about the interface between the systems.
Okay, there's another comment by Ellen.
Yes. Yes, Ellen, you know that Microsoft will not develop SharePoint over 2022. So Drupal has to be changed to with another system in some years. There are a lot of different alternatives you can handle it. SharePoint has great functionality, especially for working with files and permissions and so. A lot of things you can do. Microsoft, yes, exactly. And Microsoft has also developed plugins to connect with Moodle, but they have not maintained this. And this is a problem there because the connection is not very well. If you are working in the very lot in the or neatly in the Microsoft environment, you should also think about how can we combine this with Office 365. There are a lot of functionalities, and our colleagues in US from Remote Learners have developed the interface together with Microsoft, Moodle with Office 365, and maybe it makes sense to think about this for you.
Any more questions while you get the chance to grab him? But also, as you know, there's a course forum for the session. So if you think of some questions afterwards, I'm sure that Ralph will react to those as well.
Okay. I will also upload the presentation file here. And you see my contact data here in the final page of the presentation, and you can contact me afterwards, no problem. Guido, does it change the Moodle a lot? No, it didn't. We have disabled some functionality, it's a connection, this was one point that we didn't change things in the Moodle system. I think there are two or three lines of code that we have customized, but not more, because we are using standard functionalities of interconnection between the tools.
Okay. Thank you ever so much.
It
was really, really interesting. Great stuff to see how you can get several pieces of software working together in such an integrated and then seamless experience for most people using it. That's really good. I'm sure the others are joining me in my thanks. And don't forget that Ralph's got other sessions coming up as well. Check the schedule. And if you like this one, make your people aware of the recording, perhaps, and they can check this out. Thanks, Ralph. I will stop the recording now after you can say goodbye to everybody. And then we'll just see whether people have got any more things to say.
Bye.